St. Lucia is taking a major step towards confirming the elimination of schistosomiasis, also known as bilharzia. While the prevalence of the disease is at extremely low levels, with only 36 cases recorded in the past decade, the World Health Organization, WHO, requires countries to demonstrate zero cases to confirm elimination status. The Ministry of Health, Wellness and Elderly Affairs is conducting a national survey among primary school students and is also ramping up public education efforts about schistosomiasis. National epidemiologist Dr. Michelle Fressois has been sharing comprehensive information about the disease, its transmission, and its impact, and urges the public to exercise vigilance to prevent its resurgence.
Schistosomiasis, also known as bilharzia, is a parasitic infection which is transmitted to humans when they are exposed to fresh water, which is contaminated with the parasite being a worm. And the worm itself can penetrate the skin and cause infection in humans.
As Dr. Fressois elaborated on the signs and symptoms of schistosomiasis, she highlighted a critical aspect of the disease. Many individuals may remain asymptomatic for months or even years after infection. The silent nature of the disease underscores the importance of awareness and early detection.
The most characteristic would be when the worm penetrates the skin, there may be a slight rash in the area, accompanied by itching. Some individuals may get fever. Once inside the body, the worm moves its way to different organs. So it can go to the liver, it can go to the intestine, where the individual may start experiencing abdominal pain or diarrhea. It also has an affinity for the bladder, so individuals may develop urine with blood in it and low abdominal pain as well. And this can go on for an extended period of time.
Dr. Fressois highlighted that preventative measures such as improved sanitation, clean water access, and community health education have been pivotal in reducing the disease's prevalence in St. Lucia. She encouraged residents to adopt protective behaviors such as avoiding contact with untreated water in high-risk areas.
Within the life cycle of the parasite, what happens is once it penetrates the human, it lives there for a period of time and it passes out eggs, and humans pass out these eggs in the feces or the stool. So if individuals excrete in the rivers or they dump the stool in the rivers, then they are putting the population at risk. So essentially, persons should avoid areas where they know that these things do happen. And of course, if you are going out farming or in these areas, ensure that you have boots and your skin is not exposed to the soil or the swampy areas.
By educating the public and conducting targeted surveys, the ministry is taking significant steps towards confirming the elimination of schistosomiasis in country. From the Communications Unit of the Ministry of Health, Wellness and Elderly Affairs, I am Onika McCoy.